Right now, very few Democrats are endorsing this deal. That's why Vice President Joe Biden himself came to Capitol Hill today to try to sell the package to his own party.
Biden's message to Senate Democrats that this deal is as good as it's going to get was not well received.
I would say it wasn't warm and fuzzy.
What angers Democrats most is that the president broke his campaign promise to block any extension of the Bush tax cuts for wealthy Americans.
Extend tax breaks for the middle class, protect the unemployed. Do not drive up the national debt by giving tax breaks to millionaires and billionaires who don't need it and in many cases don't even want it.
They're also outraged over the cost of an estate tax compromise that would reduce the taxes on inheritance from 45% to 35% and impose them only on estates of $5 million or more.
So I'm not a big fan of what has been negotiated, but we have to realize where we are.
Even the Speaker of the House pointedly withheld her support, releasing a frosty statement that read in part, "We will continue discussions with the president." Republicans, on the other hand, are heaping praise on the compromise. "The right thing to do for our country," crowed Senator Lamar Alexander.
"I'm very hopeful and optimistic that a large majority of members of the Republican conference will find this proposal worth supporting."
Republicans point out the deal extends several tax credits from the president's own stimulus package, including an expansion of the earned income tax credit and the child tax credit. Plus, there's a cut in payroll taxes, which essentially amounts to a 2% pay raise for workers. A person making $50,000 annually would take home an extra $1,000 next year.
Anyone who works for a living is going to pay less taxes in 2011 than they would have paid without this compromise.
The biggest problem for the president right now is that the Democratic leaders who he normally relies on to sell his proposals to the rank and file have significant reservations themselves and feel like they were cut out of the negotiations between the White House and Republicans. Jeff?
Nancy Cordes on Capitol Hill. Nancy, thank you.